Swing Good Sell. I finished uploading the first video of the day, my plan to save the world. It's not complicated, but our institutions cannot be relied upon. And as I was going through the comments, there were a couple of abusive spams that I got rid of, but there was one in particular that is demonstrating first indications of coronavirus deniers. This is a thing that popped up after World War II. There were Nazi Holocaust deniers. It was done purposely as an anti-Semitic attack. But it carried over into other areas as deniers of other historical facts popped up and emerged. And you end up seeing people trying to rewrite history based on this denier's occurrence. And in some cases, history does need to be added to, such as the founding of America sort of left out much of the atrocities of slavery and capitalist greed. But to tear down history or to deny history is the danger. And so with coronavirus, we're again seeing this pop up as the guy is trying to promote a coronavirus denier scenario, where I did my video from the Johns Hopkins University study or status update of coronavirus, calling it fake news. In essence, he doesn't use those words. He calls them lie offenders, aka the media. Says that nobody's died, that all these reports of deaths are wrong. They're a cover-up. And I can understand where that comes from. The media has lied to us throughout our history. They've purposely created a bias scenario to take us down a path that they want us to go down. That's part of the brainwashing technique for mass population control. And so I can understand where he's coming from. But there's an overriding scenario in this particular case with coronavirus. Now, we know that Trump came out first and called it a hoax. And people are dying. Now, if it's a hoax, as Trump originally said, because now he's switched, he's now calling it a pandemic, he's now activated the National Guard. We're now under martial law. And that's the whole point, is that if it's a hoax, guess what they've done to us? They've fired us, they've isolated us at homes, and now they've implemented the National Guard to force us at home. They're not providing us with test kits, they're not providing us with anything that can prove that we're not sick and that we're perfectly healthy and able to work. And now they're forcing us in our homes, implementing the National Guard as security and assistance, all fascist tools. And that's what people need to realize, is that if coronavirus is a hoax, it's not a hoax that we've been fired and that our grocery stores are limited on food, because I've seen it firsthand. I'm a witness, as I know most, if not all of you, are also witnesses, having gone to your grocery stores to look for things. And so the media is correct on the runs on the grocery stores, because we've proven that much. But if coronavirus is a hoax, and that everybody's in on it to cover it up and create a mass hysteria and panic to force everybody into lockdown, the lockdown is not a fake news. It's real. And our lives are being taken over by fascism. That is not fake. That is real. They're using coronavirus, and it doesn't matter if it's real or fake. That's what they used to implement the new world order of fascism in America. The takeover of our government, the takeover of our lives. And so, if you're going to be a coronavirus denier, understand that our lives are now in bondage. We are under the control of fascist government. The takeover is complete. That's not a hoax. That's reality. So, understand that. And if it is coronavirus, if coronavirus is real, and that people are getting sick with this contagion and dying, it still does not justify the fascist takeover of America. Because that just adds to the criminality of the whole thing. Taking advantage of Americans with an actual virus. But this person needs to understand he's neglecting the depopulation agenda of the rich elite that he's talking about in the psychological operation. Is that they've been trying to complain for years that, oh, we're overpopulating the world. Oh, there's no more room for humans. Seriously? As all these decades go by and there's still plenty of room for humans? So, you know, and America still produces enough food waste that gets thrown away that could have fed the whole world multiple times over. So there is no population fear, overpopulation fear, and they purposely caused the climate problem to blame humans for that, when it was industry, combustion engines that have been obsolete for over 100 years now. Yeah, they want to blame humans so that they can justify murder. That's why they're doing all this. And so you have to be able to pay attention to what people are telling us and not get caught up and carried away like he thinks I am with the media. I'm not the only one who's talked about a Mormon dying in Utah. The Utah news I'm seeing this morning is covering the whole thing now. So it's confirmed. So even though I'm not an authorized news source, the authorized news sources are confirming what I already identified. So pay attention. Again, I've got a plan. In a crisis situation, you need to implement immediate measures. Not fascism, you know, life-saving rescue measures that have long-term saving effects, not control effects, not taking away agency effects. And that's what they're doing to us, is they're taking away our agency and exterminating us. So understand this, that we are at war and we have been conquered.